Skeletons, it's Disney Queen Skelly here, and welcome back to another Creepy Stories About Disneyland. So, this is going to be another 17 creepy stories and legends about Disney. I really hope that you guys enjoyed the first video because it was a lot of work to actually make. You'll see my behind the scenes. If you haven't seen my behind the scenes already, doing this for you guys is a lot of work, but I'm not going to explain it now. Go watch my behind the scenes and then you'll see why this is such a big deal. But if you guys again have any creepy Disney legends that you or like stories or whatever that you want me to talk about, please let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to talk about them, maybe make full episodes about them. But for now, here are 17 creepy stories and legends about Disneyland. Walt Disney haunts his old apartment. The light is kept on in Walt Disney's former apartment above the firehouse on Main Street for a reason. According to the legend, one night an employee came in to dust and turned off the lights when she left. The light reportedly turned on and off as she attempted to leave. Some versions of the story claim that she heard a voice say, "Don't forget, I'm still here." There's a ghost rider on Space Mountain. Single rider? No problem. The ghost of Game of Thrones raider Tormund Giantsbane, yes, or at least someone who looks like him, is said to sometimes sit next to riders. The apparition is described as a large man with reddish hair. He's supposedly the ghost of a deceased guest who died on the ride back in the 70s. He politely disappears before the end of the ride. There are real bones in parts of the Caribbean. Disney Imagineers used real human bones to construct the Scallywag skeletons when the attraction first opened in 1967. The fake bones looked well fake, so Imagineers procured real ones from UCLA's medical school. Eventually, they were replaced with phony ones. However, many believe that one or more skulls in the ride are still real. A Disneyland ghost was caught on camera. The video is a bit shaky, but a security camera apparently caught a ghost casually strolling through Disneyland. Many have dismissed it as monitor burn or reflection, but many others believe it's a real ghost, possibly Javier Cruz. This cast member played Pluto and was killed in 2004 after falling in front of a parade float at Disneyland. People keep scattering human remains around the park. Occasionally, people sneakily scatter the ashes of loved ones at Disneyland, including at the parts of the Caribbean, where in 2007 a woman was seen pouring a powdery substance into the water. The Haunted Mansion is another site where visitors have honored their loved ones by leaving ashes behind. In October 2018, Disney staff from both parks confirmed to the Wall Street Journal that not only do the people scatter their ashes at the park, but the practice is so popular that the maintenance staff has a code for it, HEPA cleanup, which refers to an air filter system that picks up ultra-fine dust particles. The Haunted Mansion probably has so much human ashes in it that it's not even funny, one custodian told the publication. The Lady in White. Disneyland wasn't always Disneyland. A legend tells of a mysterious lady in white in turn-of-the-century clothing who perished in the early 1900s on the land where Disneyland stands today. She allegedly walks Main Street, appearing in and near stores. Dolly's Dip. Dolly Young was in a bobsled on the Matterhorn ride in 1984. Young is said to have unbuckled herself to assist a child on the ride. As she stood up, she hit the cross track overhead just before a dip and was thrown onto the tracks, where she was then run over by the next bobsled. Since her death, Disneyland employees have experienced a feeling of being watched around Dolly's Dip as they walk the track after the park closes. A rotating stage grinds to a halt. Deborah Stone worked as a host at the America Sings attraction in 1974. Unfortunately, the 18-year-old employee was killed when she became trapped between the attraction's rotating stages. Following her death, cast members have said they hear Stone reminding them to be careful. Ghost of the Monorail. A teenager attempted to sneak into Disneyland in 1966 by climbing a fence. As he crossed the monorail track, he was struck by the train, then dragged approximately 40 feet. Over the years, monorail riders and park workers have reportedly seen the ghost of the 19-year-old running alongside the train. It's a haunted world after all. The Haunted Mansion isn't the only spooky ride at Disneyland. In a viral meme, a guest describes a first haunt account of riding It's a Small World in 1999 when it suddenly stopped. The lights came on and everyone was asked to exit the boats. The guest's mother decided to take some pictures to use up the film roll on their camera and snapped a picture of what looks like a child dangling from the rafters. Some believe that a kid took their life, others blame mischievous cast members, or the image may be a hoax. Disco Debbie still grooving at Space Mountain. An employee dubbed Disco Debbie, who mysteriously died of a brain aneurysm backstage at Space Mountain, still seemingly haunts the out-of-this-world ride. She's been spotted several times by guests and cast members. They describe her as a green flying ghost. The crying boy at the exit. Here's another legend. A small boy has been seen crying near the exit of the Haunted Mansion. Some believe he's the ghost of a child whose ashes were scattered at the ride. Most enduring Haunted Mansion ghost. The rumor has lingered for decades. A person who visited the Haunted Mansion prior to its official opening in 1969 found the attraction so scary that they had a heart attack and died. The ride was remade to be made less frightening. Perhaps this person has become one of the many real ghosts spotted in or near the Haunted Mansion. About those It's a Small World dolls, Disneyland employees have shared stories about the It's a Small World dolls changing positions, disappearing, or coming to life. Some have said their hair even appears to grow. However, even without those tall tales, the dolls are still creepy all on their own. The Haunted Mansion musical ghost. Before the Haunted Mansion opened in 1969, a worker heard music coming from the walls in the seance room. He thought a radio had been accidentally walked in, although the tunes were never interrupted by a DJ or commercials. The music was so persistent that it compelled the worker to install speakers to draw out the noise. Cast members honor Grandma Joyce. Haunted Mansion employees found an empty urn buried in the flower bed near the ride's entrance with the plaque reading, "Rest in peace, our dearest Grandma Joyce." Apparently, the grandmother's ashes were spread somewhere within the attraction. The urn remained in the ride's video camera room until the employees placed it in the catwalks above the graveyard scene. And those are your 17 creepy facts and... not facts. Creepy urban legends and stories surrounding Disneyland. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, little skeletons. Stay safe. Love you guys.